Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where I review the latest and the greatest movies. This week, I'm going to be discussing Venom. Before we get to that, just a little bit about me and the show. Here at The Review, I will always offer my recommended viewing guide. I will recommend that you go and see it if I think that it's worth the price of admission. I'll recommend that you stay home and stream it if I think you'll enjoy it just as much from the comfort of whatever screen you like to watch your things on. And I will recommend that you skip it if I didn't enjoy it, and I do not think that you will either. That is not the case today. Now, I am certainly a comic book fan. I've seen and enjoyed all of the Marvel movies. I've seen all of the DC movies. Burn. And I went into this movie like really expecting to have seen it and that to be the end of it. I had high hopes going in. I really wanted to enjoy it. I was certainly nervous because the last time that we had seen Venom portrayed on screen was in Spider-Man 3, which I used to waste a lot of breath defending. That movie isn't very fun. And it has aged poorly. One of the things that had me super nervous going into Venom was I thought that the CGI might be a little bit jarring. I was afraid there would be too much of it, and there was not. I thought that they did a really good job of keeping all of the CGI scenes relatively short. They kept everything pretty rounded in the reality that they had established. And I never thought that the CGI took away from the story, which in getting ready for this video, watching a few clips from Spider-Man 3, it certainly did take away from it in that. So Venom was a success out the gate, just even aesthetically. Now, going into it, I had seen the previews, and I have not had many experiences where a preview would leave me hot or cold. The first round of previews certainly left me being like, oh no. Then eventually there was a preview that made me pretty excited about it. Once I saw that Michelle Williams would be in this movie, she is one of my favorite performers today, and also is in the running for a award for my favorite performer of the year with her performance from I Feel Pretty. I will be keeping everyone updated as award season comes along for my nominations, and ultimately we'll be having an award show where I just acknowledge all of my favorite performances of the year, and Michelle Williams in I Feel Pretty was certainly one of my favorites. She is a great actress, and I always enjoy her work. I appreciate that she makes strong actorly choices, and in this, I would say she played a character that was deeper than it had to be and more rooted in reality than the story demanded her to be. And it was those choices that helped make this story much, much more enjoyable than I was worried that it might not be. Venom is rated PG-13. If you had asked me, I would have said that it was rated R for violence before I checked. It is an adult action movie. I would say that there are threats of violence as well as violence shown on screen. I was surprised that it was rated PG-13. Take that as you will. I would say definitely check it out. Before you show this movie to your young kids, I would say watch it yourself. It is violent, and I also was a little nervous that this movie might have a few more horror elements than I was expecting it to. Based on some of the later previews, there's a lot of spooky science labs in those previews, and I'm happy to note that Venom is not a horror movie. Like I was saying, it's certainly a sort of a sci-fi action movie, certainly a comic book action movie, and I think that the performers ground this movie in a reality that feels tangible and real. My favorite performance of the movie, obviously the reason for the season, Tom Hardy as Venom, I thought was fantastic. I thought that he did a lot of fun things with his voice. In researching this, I found out that he recorded all of his voice parts before the live action recording, which I think was really neat. And what he did was he had an earpiece in so he could be interacting with his performance as Venom. I thought that it really helped the performance, and I never had any problems with the dual personality. That being said, I did think that Riz Ahmed's character eventually, moderate spoilers, there are other characters in this movie than only Venom, and I did think that some of his voice choices seemed a little bit campy. Didn't take away from the movie very much. It is, yet again a comic book movie. One of the things that I enjoyed when I was researching for this video is the writer of this movie was Scott Rosenberg, aka the writer of Con Air, and a man that I saw give a talk a few months ago now. Cool to see something that he had worked on, and again, when the movie was over, the feeling of relief that my wife and I felt as we looked over at each other from a job well done that we were nervous would not be. I certainly credit good part of that to the writing. Scott Rosenberg, yet again, great stuff. One thing that you do want to keep a lookout for with this movie is you do want to stay through the very end of the credits. There are two post-credit scenes, and the second one is way cooler. And also, I would say that if you enjoyed the movie Zombieland a couple years ago, it was directed by the same director, Ruben Fleischer. If you haven't seen that, check it out. And if you did, definitely take those warm and fuzzy feelings into Venom with you. If you are nervous about seeing it because some of the critics have been especially harsh, I would say take it into your own hands. Certainly feel free to wait to stream it. The CGI does not need to be seen on a big screen. I think it will live on any size screen just as well. And I would say, yet again, treat yourself, wait for it, stream Venom when you have the opportunity. My name is Johnny Vaught, and this has been The Review.